Thank you guys for that. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, Steve, remember when Vince wanted to call you the Black Stud? Isn't that awesome? Right before the Ringmaster and all the stuff you did. I do want to make mention that really quickly, there's three guys who I've thought I've always wanted to wrestle, and they're here tonight. One of them was John Cena. I've never had the chance to wrestle him. That would be a great match. It would be a great match. The other one who I've always wanted to wrestle, and he knows this, is Rey Mysterio Jr. Always. And finally, there's a guy here. Well, listen, what I was going to say. When I was 14 years old, this man came in and wrestled for my grandmother in Hawaii. And I thought even then, man, I'd love to get in the ring with him, because he was awesome then, he's awesome now. It would be a great match, is Shawn Michaels. Oh, that would be great. God, you're very light. I could pick you up. Rock bottom, very easy. Hold on. Clearly, there's some great alcohol here in Orlando. I need to lighten it up, actually, before I say this. The great High Chief Peter Maivia. He was many things to a lot of people. But to my family, he was everything. He was compassionate, he was loving, fierce, extraordinarily loyal. He was a warrior who loved this business, loved his family even more. My grandfather's integrity in this business was unparalleled. When my family reflect on him, we discuss the fact that he had such a great effect on people's lives, all the lives that he touched. He was truly a man who was universally loved and respected. His matches were historic, working with such greats as the great Harley Race, Chief J. Strongbow, superstar Billy Graham, Bob Backlund. And of course, in San Francisco, his matches with Pat Patterson were the matches that dreams were made of. My grandfather had immeasurable charisma. He charmed people all over the world, whether he was a strong baby face or a very vicious heel. When I think of him, I can't help but think of the special quality that he had. He had a great spirit to him. He had a warrior spirit to him. My grandfather was a Paramount High Chief who had tattoos from the bottom of his chest all the way down to his knees, 360 degrees. It's very similar to what I have tattooed on my arms and my chest now. My grandfather was known as one of the toughest men in this business, ever. But what set him apart, he was the kindest. And for those of you who don't know, he was extremely kind. And for those of you who do know him, you can attest to this. Let's take a look at my grandfather, the great High Chief, Peter Maivia. Before we go on, I have to introduce someone. His wife, my grandmother, Leah Maivia. Please stand up, Grandma. My grandmother, who just turned 80 years old this year. Sorry, Grandma. Sorry. Easy. Who gave my grandmother whiskey? Easy. My grandmother, who just turned 80 this year, was one of the very first female promoters in our world of professional wrestling and sports entertainment. It was those images that we just saw of my grandfather and his amazing performances and his magnetic personality that inspired me to be part of this business. They inspired me to become a professional wrestler. My dad and my grandfather are the cornerstones of my career. And when that dream came true, when I stepped in the WWE ring for the first time in 1996, my sole purpose at that time was to just make my family proud. From my mom, to my dad, to my grandmother, to Danny. To our little girl, Simone, I've always asked the question. My final question is this, is Grandpa, as Grandpa, I hope I've made you proud. Because I sure am so proud of you. I usually get $15 million to cry in movies. I needed that, thank you. To induct my grandfather into the 2008 WWE Hall of Fame, please welcome the real rock of the family, my mom, his daughter, Atta Johnson.
Thank you, son. First, I want to say that I've been around the wrestling business now for almost 50 years. I'm used to being on that side of the stage. So when my son asked me to speak on behalf of my mother, in honor of my father, my first reaction was, no way, that'll never happen. If I can't speak or talk about my father without getting emotional in front of my own family and friends, how can I possibly do it in front of 10,000 people, let alone millions? Thank you. 10,000 people, let alone millions and millions. Thank you. Millions on TV, yet here I am. I have asked my son to stand by just in case, and I hope you'll understand if I get emotional and falter. It's a wonderful thing about the wrestling grapevine of wrestlers and their families. No matter where you go or what you do, somebody always knows how so-and-so is doing. And when we see each other, no matter how many years have passed, it's as if We were on the road together just yesterday. From here, it's great to see dear faces that I haven't seen in years, and you all look so fabulous. Yes, you do. My father, High Chief Peter Fanene Leifi Maivia, used to preach in the little church that he and my mother helped to build in a little town called Tokoroa in New Zealand. Their names as founders are still engraved in the cornerstone of that little church. When my father broke into the business by way of promoter Steve Ricard in New Zealand, in Auckland, New Zealand, I was just 10 years old. When we left for Europe in the early 60s, people there just didn't know how to take this big, happy, smiling fella with the long, curly hair and the colorful skirt. In Samoa, it's a lava lava, but in England, it was half a dress. And the other English word for dress is frock. So many times, I'd want to come out swinging. I was 16. When I would hear, "Call blimey, that bloke's in a frock." Well, ladies and gentlemen, the man in that frock was the toast of Europe. It was there that my father met greats like George Gordienko, Gordon Nelson, Billy Robinson, Andre Bolle, Paul Vachon, to name a few. Yes. And it was in Paris that we first met a very tall, lanky young wrestler just starting out. Later on, he became famous as Andre the Giant. We left Europe for New Zealand in 1968, and we stopped over in Hawaii. The rest was history. Here in Hawaii, my father met a prince, a king, and a lord. Prince Nef Maiava, King Curtis Yokea, and Lord Tallyho Blairs. From Hawaii to the mainland, where he met legends. Ray Stevens, Pat Patterson. The superstar Billy Graham. Harley Race, Cyclone Negro, the Funks. Pepe Gomez, Pedro Morales. Bob Backlund and his future son-in-law, Rocky Soman Johnson. One night at the Cow Palace in San Francisco, my father was wrestling Pat Patterson. My dad, who wrestled in his bare feet, broke his big toe. Thanks, Pat. He sat down in the middle of that ring and he took his toe, bent it back into its rightful place, and they continued the match. Patterson still shivers when he tells the story. I have been asked many times if I was ever interested in following my father's footsteps and getting into the business myself. Well, years ago, in my early teens in Belgium, I was interested for about 2 days. I begged my dad to let me be his ring valet. He did it so I could learn respect and appreciate the wrestling profession. I did it so I could get in the locker rooms. Okay. Unfortunately, my dad made me sit in his corner throughout his matches. I never saw the inside of a locker room. I quit. It was a very short-lived career. What did I know? I was just a 16-year-old kid. There's a little gnat flying around, and I'm trying to avoid it going in my mouth. When I married into the business, I just wasn't old enough. Hi, Rocky. Honey. When our little pebble grew up and became the rock.
Sorry, let's just, for the record, please don't ever start that chant ever.
He did us proud. He did us proud. Oh, and by the way, I was reminded earlier not to go on and on about my son. The reminder came from my son. So I'll just say this about him. It was only right that he get into the ring and start laying the Samoan smack down on all those candy whatevers. And I have to say, appreciate that. He's a grown man. He can do what he wants. I have to say, I have to say that every time Dwayne got in the ring, I would wish that his grandfather could just see him now. I know he would be so proud of Dwayne, as we are. My father was a soft-spoken, gentle giant of a Samoan man with a loving, generous heart and a beautiful, beautiful voice. He always had his ukulele handy, and with a smile and a song, that man lived his life to the fullest. He loved this business. But that's a trait that is shared by his fellow wrestlers. You give your all to this business, don't you? That says a lot. I applaud you, men and women, for your passion and your love for your chosen profession. For my dad, I want to thank all the men mentioned above who shared the glory days with him in the ring and on the highways. Thanks to the Skolans, the Monsoons, the Strongbows of the industry. They took my father by the hand along the way. Thank you to our family members present, the Wao Samoans, Afansika, my brother Tonga, the Superfly, and the Deuce. To my father's children, Peter and sister Atua and Toa, Dad would be so proud of you guys. There's no better time for me to say from my heart, what a phenomenal grand platform on which we proudly stand to honor our loved ones and the legends of professional wrestling. Dwayne, great job. Great job. I love you, son. Danny, you continue to inspire like no other. I love you. And to my granddaughter, Simone, hey, Sunga, grandma will be home soon. Okay. Umanga. By the way, Umanga, I know what your name means, and it's not anything to do with the monkey. To my mother, Mom, thank you for loving my father. A huge thank you to the fans, for without you, wrestlers would not aspire to inspire. And Ric Flair, indeed, you do inspire. I don't know about that. This is a proud day. It's a proud day for my family. My heart is pounding. We have lived and loved this wrestling business all of our lives. Here we are, the Hall of Fame. And Dad, as you look down from heaven, take your final bow. This is your big finish. And as we say in the business, it's time to go home. So Dad, with your warrior heart pumping and your spirit soaring, soak in the applause just off the crowd just one more time. One more last time, Dad, you are my champion. I love you.